طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله we'll start with the book of Salah, book of prayer from بلوغ المرام. As you know, we already finished the first part, which is the book of Tahara, purification. And we started last week as introduction for the book of Salah, and we mentioned the importance of Salah and why Salah or prayer is very important. We mentioned many different reasons. You know, we said that Salah was commanded directly to the Prophet ﷺ from Allah Azza wa Jal without any mediator. Salah was commanded on the highest place, which is above the seven heaven, Laylatul Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, which is the most honored place, the most honored time. Subhanallah. Salah is the only type of ibadah that a Muslim should do to the best of his ability in all conditions, even when he is sick, even at the time of war, even at the time of fighting with a battle. This to show you why Salah is very important, that Muslim never ever neglect Salah and do it on time. So today, inshallah, we'll start about the first subject, which is relate to Salah, which is about Al-Mawaqit. It's called Mawaqit. Mawaqit is plural of Miqat, which is time barriers or limits, time limit. So the times of Salah, Mawaqit of Salah, times of Salah. Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا مَوْقُوتًا prescribed to believers on what? And prescribed time. Salah and prescribed time. طيب. This to show you that why the Shaykh started with Bab al-Mawaqit. When he started talking about Salah, the first matter that he talk about Salah is the time. Why? To show you the importance of time. Right? Is timing part of the Salah or not part of the Salah? Be careful. This will lead us to understand three different things which relate to the ibadah or salat or any acts of worship. In any act of ibadah, there are two or three issues or matters or factors or components, whatever you call it. There are conditions, there are furud, which is genuine parts, which is, you know, the origin parts or compulsory parts, and there is must, which is also should be done but less than the arkan, and there is also sunan, which is recommended. So we have shurut, we have furud, we have wajibat, and we have sunnah. Four matters you need to know when you talk about any act of ibadah. Shurut, conditions. One is shart, one condition. Shurut, conditions. And we have furud. Furud, which is the original part or must or obligatory parts of the act of ibadah. نعم. وفروض. This plural. فرض. فرض. Is one. Right. We have واجبات. Must. طيب. And واجبات. Plural is. And the singular is what? واجب. واجب. And we have سنن. Which is recommended. And one is sunnah. So we have sunnah, we have condition, we have شرط واجب فرض واجب سنة. طيب طيب in every عبادة you will find these things. نعم. So when we talk about conditions, what are the differences? ما الفرق بين الشرط والواجب؟ What is the difference between شرط, conditions and must? Be careful. The conditions, it's not part of the ibadah, but it is pre-request for the ibadah. Pre-request. That means it should be met before you start any act of worship and should continue till you finish this act of worship. Let's explain this. Now, for Salah. Salah. One of the conditions of Salah is Tahara. Right or not? One of the conditions to perform Salah that you should have wudu. Right? So wudu is what? Shart. We don't say it is must, it is shart. Why we don't say must and we say shart? Because wudu should be there before you start the salah. Before you start the salah, you should have the wudu. You cannot say Allahu Akbar unless you have wudu. So this is shart. Right? Right. And also this wudu or this shart should continue till you finish your salah. That means if during your salah, even before you say salam at the sitting, before you say salam and you conclude your salah, if you break your wudu, alaykum as-salam, you break your wudu before you finish this salah, what happened? Now your salah is khalas, invalid, null. You say, no, but I pray the first rak'ah, the second rak'ah, the third rak'ah, the fourth rak'ah. It's only before I say salam. We say, yes, but this wudu is condition and you didn't keep this condition till you finish your salah. Before you say salam, you break your wudu. Either by blessing God or any other reason. You got it? So this is what consider or called shart, condition. Now you know what does it mean, shart? Be careful. My dear brothers, it's very important to know the definition of terms. Because when you know the definition, this will help you to understand many things. So this is shart, condition. Right? Which is different from obligatory part, the salah. Like for example, now we come to the salah. What are components of salah? We have three. We have rukun, pillar, na'am. We have must, obligatory act, and we have sunnah, recommended. Na'am. Like for example, saying takbir al-ihram, the first takbir, this is rukun, pillar. Ruku', position. Sujood, all these are considered as arkan, rukun, pillar. This is pillar. طيب. There are other parts, it's not pillar, but it is must also. That the person should do it. What are they? Like for example, sitting for tashahud, the first tashahud. Like for example, saying Subhana Rabbi al-A'la when you are in the prostrated position, or saying Subhana Rabbi al-Azim when you are on the ruku'. These are what? Must. That means the Muslim should not miss them and he should do it. And there is sunan.
recommends. If he did it, that's perfect. If he didn't do it, his salah is still valid. Like, for example, holding hands. This is not must, not obligatory or better. For example, if a person is say Allah Akbar, he pray and he didn't hold his hand, his salah is what? Still valid. But to follow the sunnah, you hold. Raising hand, these are sunnah. Now you see this difference now? So how many terms we have today, to learn them today?
Four.
What are they? First, condition, shart. Second, fard. Na'am, which is bilar or must. And then wajib, which is must. And then sunnah. Three of them are part of the salah. Which are? The rukun, the wajib, and the sunnah. Bilar, obligatory, and sunnah. These are of the component of the salah. And the fourth one is pre-request for the salah, which is condition, al-shart. You need to understand and to know the difference between these four terms. Those who come late, please go back to the video, the Facebook, to recover what we just studied, what we said. It's very important to understand the rest of the lesson. Khalas? And it's very important to understand what we are going to talk about. So today, we start with what? With conditions. So the Sheikh said, he started with chapter on time of Salah. Like, why did he start with timing, not with wudu? Good question, right? You know, everybody now, when he said, I want to go Salah, the first thing he think about is what? Wudu. And tahara. Like, why he did started with time, not with wudu?
Because Salah is related to time.
Because the timing is more important than the wudu. Can you imagine this? Timing, or do the Salah on time, is more important than the wudu. Because the wudu is condition, and the timing is a condition. But if you have to miss one of them, then it's okay to waive wudu, but not time. So how come? That means if the time of the salah started, you try your best to perform wudu, either by getting water or making tayammum. A person is captive. He cannot move, or a sick person, there's nobody to help him to perform wudu or perform tayammum. And you look, and the time of salah will expire. What should he do? He pray without wudu. But you cannot say, no, inshallah, after 1 hour, my son or my friend will come and help me to make wudu, and then I can perform salah. We said no. Why? Because the salah should be done on time. On time. This is very important, my dear brothers. Unfortunately, many Muslims, they don't realize this. This is why some people, for example, they go to work or to they play, or they go, for example, to market. Especially women. Because, you know, they find hard time, you know, it's hard sometimes to perform wudu or to go to the toilet. So they move, they get out of their homes before Maghrib, and they go to the market making shopping, and then the Adhan Maghrib come, and they will not finish their shopping till after Isha. But they said, okay, alhamdulillah, when I go home, I will inshallah make wudu and pray Maghrib. But when you reach home, the time of Maghrib is already what?
Over.
And this is a great sin. Very major sin. So this is very important to understand. Time is the first and the most important condition for the salah and the first element that the Muslim should think about. That, for example, if he didn't know the Qibla, he can pray to any direction after he do whatever he want. If he doesn't have wudu, he turn to tayammum. If he cannot do tayammum, if he don't have clothes to cover himself, he sit and pray, but don't wait and said after 1 hour or 2 hours somebody will get me some clothes and cover myself and pray. If waiting for this time will make the time for the salah is what? Expired. Is it clear? So what's the most important thing? Time. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta." طيب. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله. طيب. If you look at the timing of salah, it is mercy from Allah Azza wa Jal. Because if he commanded us to do this in one time, it will take maybe 30 minutes or 1 hour. And then we will be what? Heedless for the rest of the 24 hours. We must not think about our relation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it is mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal that he subhanahu wa ta'ala plan this time to keep you always connected with him, always connected with Allah Azza wa Jal, because subhanallah, he is your, the source of your power, of your happiness. So look at the time and look at the wisdom of Allah. When you wake up in the morning, the first thing that comes to your mind is salah. In fact, the only maybe thing that should wake you up is salah. Right? Salatul Fajr. So we wake and tell you also, as-salatu khayru min an-nawm. Prayer is more better than sleeping. So you start your salah, your day, with turning to the one who created you. And this does mean blessing for the rest of the whole day. When you are at the middle of the work, you are working, you know, at noon, you are involved in the middle of your business. The call come and said, Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. He's greater than what you are doing. He's greater than the thing or the business that you are busy with. Allahu Akbar. Hayya ala salah, come to prayer. Hayya ala al-falah, come to success. So while you are thinking, in this ocean of business and life matters, the call to salah come to remind you that turn your face to the one who created you and provided you with all these things. This, my dear brother, is very important. That means keep the believer, keep the Muslim free. Not to be enslaved by business, by money, by anything in this life. So I'm not enslaved with meeting, with work, with any other activities. Which means train you as Muslim that you are the one who manage, you are the one who have control over your time. Not the business, not the schedule, not what people want you to do. Take you out to look around you, to connect you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you pray what? You pray. After you finish your job, also you take a break. People, you know, at 12 o'clock care about lunch break, right? Lunch break. Nobody forget this. When it comes to, it's my lunch time. MashaAllah. Great. They remember about the lunch time, the food of the body, And many people are not aware of what? Huh? The fuel of the soul, which is more important. More than, what is the body? The body is just a ride. You see, like a rider and a rider and the horse. Which one most important? Huh? The rider or the horse? The one who rides the horse, right? The soul is the rider. And the body is like the horse, the container, just a container. Because at the time of death, this body will turn to dust. This soul that will go up, if it's good, to Jannah, if it is not, to hell, but it's still alive. So this is the real genuine part, the component of man, soul. So many people, they care about their body, about time for lunch, food, but they forget about most important, which is the fuel of what? Of the soul, which is very important. And then it's come asr, after you are taking rest, also the call come to remind you, okay? Now before time, night come to communicate with Allah. When the day is over and the sunset, also it's the end of the day and the beginning of night, transition in this universe, also you turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before you go to bed, the middle of the night or before, you pray Isha. Look to the subhanallah, the beautiful and the most unique schedule that Allah Azza wa Jalla made for you for this prayer to be connected with them. Blessing from Allah Azza wa Jalla. If you did make it only once in the morning, then you will be of your own for the whole day. And this, my dear brother, always because we as people, we as a human being, we need a break always. Always say, I need a break. Okay. Allah is giving you a break 5 times. Whenever you are get tired, when you are sinking in the ocean of this life, get you back. So remember this. So this is why, my dear brothers, it's the most important of all conditions of salah is timing. And the Muslim should do the salah even he couldn't meet the other conditions. So the first hadith, hadith number, what's the number? 129. هذا الحديث, this hadith about Abdullah ibn Amr رضي الله عنه. I'm not going to read the Arabic narration, but you can go back to your book and check this narration in Arabic, but I will say the translation. It is narrated that Abdullah ibn Amr رضي الله عنهما, he said, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the time of Dhuhr is when the sun passes the meridian and the man's shadow is of the same length as his height. We'll explain this. It lasts until the time of the Asr. The time of Asr prayer is as long as the sun has not become yellow during its setting. The time of Maghrib, which is sunset prayer, is as long as the wait has not disappeared. You see, notice in this hadith, the hadith, he mentioned only for Asr and Maghrib, the time for the end of the Salah. But he didn't mention the time of the beginning of the Salah. Why? Because you know the beginning of the time of the Salah from the previous Salah. Like for example, Salatul Dhuhr, Salatul Asr, he didn't say when it start. Why? Because it will start when? At the time of the end of Salatul Dhuhr. So he didn't mention this. But he mentioned the end of time. طيب. And the time of Isha is up to midnight. And the time of Fajr, morning prayer, is from appearance of dawn as long as the sun has not risen. طيب. The question, why this hadith started with the Dhuhr and not the Fajr? We all know as people, when is the beginning of the day for us? Huh? Morning, right or wrong? So why this hadith he didn't start with morning? Good question, right? Because Jibreel alayhi salam, when he started teaching the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started with this order. Started with this order. طيب. Anyway. Now let's explain each one of these narrations. He said, for the time of Dhuhr, when the sun passed the median, that means, you see the sun start from where? From the east. And then go up till it's reach the zenith, which is the middle of the sky. At that minute, when the sun up, then you will not find any shadow. The shadow disappear now. You notice this, right or not? At noon time, there's no shadow. And then the shadow starts in the other side. So at the beginning, when the sun starts from the east, the shadow where? To the west side. But after it's past the mid, the shadow will come where? To the east side. So when the sun reaches the mid, this is the time with the zenith, or what we call it before Zawad. This is the time which is forbidden to pray waqt before the Zawal. When the sun in the middle of the sky, there is no shadow. This is the time which is forbidden to pray any optional prayer. No sunnah, no nafila, except if there is reason for this. طيب؟ طيب. When the sun move a little bit and the shadow appeared now on this side, that means the sun moved toward the east, the west. Then this start the time of Dhuhr. The time of Dhuhr. Noon Salah. Salah. طيب. Start. طيب. Till what? The hadith said, till the shadow will be the same size of the object. That means if a person was standing, like for example, he stand, and then the shadow will come from the sun going to the west, right? And his shadow will go where? To the east side. And you see this shadow what? Will start to what? Grow. Grow. The sun is moving. Naam? To the west and to the east. The shadow will go growing now. Right? Increase. Till it reach the size of this shadow, the same size of this person. When it reached this, now this is the end of what? Of the time of Dhuhr. And then it is the start of the time of Asr. The start of the time of Asr. And then start the time of Asr from there till before sunset. Many people, they think the time of Asr is till Maghrib. Till sunset. That's wrong. But some ulama, they say there are two times. طيب. One of them they call the time of necessity. وقت ضرورة. وقت ضرورة. But the real time according to this hadith, ما لم تصفر الشمس. The time of عصر will continue unless the sun turn to yellow. Before, you know, before the sun set, you see the sun, it's not as white or bright as before, it's getting what? Yellow. When the sun turned to yellow, that means the end of Salat Al-Asr. But as we said, some ulama, they said, but if it is a necessity, then this time will be extended till Maghrib. Because there is another hadith. There's one hadith that said that if, another narration said that if one catch one rak'ah before sunset, then he catch Salatul Asr. But the ulama, they took this hadith as what? As an exception. As an exception. Because the other hadith is mentioned exactly what is the time for Salat Al Asr. Is it clear? طيب. And then when you talk about the time of Maghrib, we know the Maghrib starts when the sunset. What does it mean, sunset? When the sun disappeared. This is the time when the person, if he's fasting, what? He breaks his fast. And here, let me mention something which is very important. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he put or commanded us for these times, it wasn't, you know, linked to calculation, but to the movement of what? Of the sun. And this is more accurate and perfect. Because of what? Because of difference between different regions in the land. So you cannot say, for example, Salah should be at 12 o'clock. Because in some area, the whole day is only 6 hours. Right or not? You see? In other area, maybe the day will go to 14 hours. Or maybe 16 or 10 hours. You know, so this, some people in Ramadan, they are suffering. Like in Europe.
Yeah.
You see? The day continue very long. So subhanAllah, it's not fixed with hours. But because every area, they have their own time zone. This is why now, subhanAllah, we pray here different than Riyadh, different than other places. طيب, for Maghrib, till the red, you see the red line after Maghrib, what they call this, the toilet?
Final light.
Huh?
Final light.
Yes, right. This is the red light which come after the sun disappear. There is still some light red. Red lights that's come. And you see it in the horizon. In the horizon, in the west side where the sun disappeared. It's called the Shafaq al-Ahmar in Arabic. طيب. So, that means the sun is still not far. Disappeared, but still not far. It's still some of the shine, but it's come as red light. This mix may take maybe 1 hour, 15 minutes. Maybe 1 hour, 1 hour, 15 minutes. This time. And then it will disappear and it's become what? Dark, full dark. Now, when this light disappear, that means the end of what? Of Salat al-Maghrib and the beginning of Salat al-Isha. Isha prayer. طيب, Isha prayer, according to this hadith, إلى نصف الليل, to the middle of the night. Now, some people, they think that Salat al-Isha till Fajr. So, you know, they stay, they play, they talk, and he said, yes, salah, yes, yes, still, alhamdulillah. The whole night, you know, we still, before Fajr, we kind of pray. That's not right, not correct. Also, there's other view for some ulama that there is, it is could be extended till Fajr only for what? For necessity, for darura. Yeah. Waqtu darura, necessity. Only a person, he was in a position or situation, he couldn't pray, and he can extend this time. But it's not for anyone to just to delay the salah till after midnight. طيب. Is midnight, when we say midnight, is it 12 a.m.? Some people, they think this, right? They say, no, yeah, midnight is 12 a.m. because this is the change of the day. When it's come, at, look at your mobile, you know, the date will be changed at 12, right? Midnight. No, that's not right. This is not the mid of the night. How can you calculate the mid of the night? By calculating when the sun disappeared and sunset, and when the sun will rise. Because maybe the night could be 8 hours, it could be 7 hours, it could be 12 hours, could be 14 hours, different either by region, the geographical region or time zone. So sometimes it less or more, therefore you calculate at what time. For example, let's say that the Maghrib was at 6 o'clock and sunrise
6 o'clock again.
Let's say 4 o'clock.
Okay.
How many hours?
6 to 4, 10 hours.
We have 10 hours, right?
10 hours, yeah.
Then when is the middle of the night? Is it 12 o'clock?
5.
It will be at
11 o'clock.
At 11 o'clock. 11. You see how the calculation is?
11, yeah.
You see? So this is the time, the end of the time of Salat al-Isha. طيب. There are two, يعني سبحان الله, if you look to the Quran mentioned this timing. In two verses, he divided these times in two parts. How come two parts? They are five. Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran, أقم الصلاة لدلوك الشمس إلى غسق الليل. Establish prayer from the time of Zawal, Duluk al-Shams, when the sun pass the mid of the sky with the Zawal, ila ghasaq al-layl, till the end, you know, till the mid of the night. Now one time. And then when talk about Fajr, قال وقرآن الفجر إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا. So he talk about there is Fajr and there is other prayer. Why? Because all these four prayers were connected. That means one finish and the other one will start. So it was calculated as one time. But it doesn't mean that when you say one time that the person he can pray Maghrib at the time of Dhuhr, or he can pray Dhuhr at the time of or after Maghrib. No. Also, as detail for this, there are two prayers which you can combine during the day, and two prayers that you can combine during the night. So you can combine Dhuhr and Asr, right? When this is possible?
Traveling.
At a time traveling, or if there is need, there is need, necessity, combining Dhuhr and Asr. This why that's what they call the timing of Dhuhr Asr is one, as general, called the one time for the combined Salah. And Maghrib and Isha also will consider as what? As another combined time. Why we mention this?
Because there is no prohibited time between them.
No?
There is no prohibition.
There is no prohibition, as you said, and also because there are certain rules that should be understood and known. And this is why there are some differences between ulama, you know, about a person when salah become must in him. For example, let's say there is a woman, a lady, she was in her menses period, and then she get pure or she clean and become ready for salah before Maghrib, at time of Asr. Now, she should what? What salah she should pray? Salatul Asr. Naam? But there are some ulama who said, since she catch the time of Asr, then also she should what? Pray Duhur. This one say. We don't say this is, you know, correct view, but this one view to show you the connection between these two. But in fact, as some ulama like Shaykh bin Uthaymeen said, but the right and the most sound view that she is not responsible to pray the time of Dhuhr. Why? Because the time of Dhuhr is already expired. Is already expired when the time of Asr started. Is it clear? Now.
But if she is traveling, then she can come on and read.
Yes, but for traveler is different, yeah. This is the time of traveling.
Yeah, it becomes compulsory for her to come on.
Yes, she is traveler. Yeah. And also, by the way, combining the salah, some people, they think it's only for traveler. That's not true. There's a hadith that the Prophet, as one of Sahab said, I think Ibn Abbas said, that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he combined two prayer without fear or troubling. There was no fear and no troubling. When sometimes, like for example, if there is very strong wind, very heavy rain, there's other reason. Anyway, this is not our subject, we shall talk about it when it's come. Right. The next hadith. طيب, also we need to understand here that when we said in the salata kanat al-munina kitab al-muquta, that Muslim should not pray before the start of the time. For example, some people, they are, you know, they miss this. For example, you are at the airport, okay? You are waiting for the announcement of your flight. And it is Fajr time, Salatul Fajr. And you know that when you get in the plane, you will not pray because your flight will be 4 or 5 hours. Right? And they say that you should get into the aircraft now or they close the door. And you said, that's only about 5 minutes. And the time of Salat al-Fajr will start. So he said, we'll pray. We'll stop with the adhan and continue, inshallah. Oh. طيب. So the first most important thing that we should learn here that it is not allowed to pray the salah before what?
Time start.
So this person who thinks that it's only 5 minutes and then the time will start, we said no, you cannot pray. If you pray, then the salah is not valid. You said, but if by the time I get into the aircraft and then, you know, the salah will start. And then I cannot pray standing. I will be stuck to my seat. I say, even though you cannot start the salah before the time. So this is the first thing. Also, it is not allowed or permissible to delay the salah after the time. Right? Even, be careful, as we mentioned in the beginning, even you have to waive all other conditions. What are the conditions? We talk about it, inshallah. The most important is the time of the salah. Salat al-dhuhr or al-asr. And you feel the time will expire, but you have no water, as we said. Make tayammum. You cannot make tayammum. Okay, pray without water. A person, you have no clothes. Okay, you can sit and do your prayer. Okay, a person, he doesn't know the Qibla, but after 1 hour, somebody will come and he will show him the Qibla. We said, okay, by the time that this guy will come, the time of the salah is expired. So you can't pray. Try your best to guess where is the right direction to the Qibla. And after the time, after you pray and somebody told you, this is not the right direction, you already prayed and your prayer is is it clear? طيب. At the time when you are very busy. This is why, as we said, salah, even at the time of war, it doesn't delay. طيب. Also, how about if the person, he think that the time start, but he's not sure? He said, well, I think it is time for salah, but he's not sure. Is it okay? No, you should be sure. If you have 1% doubt that the time did not start, then you should what? You should wait to make sure. طيب. I think we here stop here. Inshallah, we'll continue with next hadith. Inshallah, next week. Do you have any questions? Yes.
Especially while we are traveling, right? For example,
yes,
there is a difference between two countries.
Raise your voice.
While we are traveling,
yes,
there is a big difference between two countries.
Yes.
When you are on the airplane especially,
yes,
which country's time we are following for sana? Is it the country we are traveling from or to?
The time where you are. You are in one place, right?
No, while you are traveling.
I know. You are traveling now to the east. When you are traveling to the east, you are losing time, right? But when you are traveling to the west, you are competing with the sun and you are gaining time, right?
Yes.
When you are in the airplane, right, at the time where you are, if it's time for the salah, then you pray. Like for example, I'll give you one example. Now, when we travel from here to New York, I know the flight here start maybe at the mid of the night sometimes, around 12 something or 1 o'clock. طيب, we already pray Isha and we pray only Fajr because we arrive at 7 o'clock a.m. But when you are coming from there to here, you pray 2 days. How can I calculate this? When you are traveling and you reach in the middle of the way, there is zone, there is area where it's time for Dhuhr, this is the time where you pray. Why? Because you cannot wait and say, okay, when I arrive to Colombo, I'll pray. But when you arrive Colombo, it's already you miss Salatul Dhuhr wal Asr, right? Because the time of Salatul Dhuhr wal Asr, it started when you are in the middle of the way. And you cannot wait till you reach this. Is it clear?
Yes.
Right. Yes, other question? No question? Good.
Yeah,
yes.
Different. One is a request to brothers to pray for Uyghur Muslims.
To?
Uyghur Muslims in China. We have to keep praying for them.
We pray for Muslims everywhere, inshallah, and especially for those who are suffering or under pressure, anywhere they are. The Muslim should care about his brothers always. The hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "من لم يهتم بأمر المسلمين فليس منهم." The one who doesn't care about about other Muslim, he's not one of them. Therefore, you pray for your Muslim brothers whenever they are, wherever they are. If you hear about any calamity or troubles happen to a Muslim in any part of the world, then you need to, you know, to include this in your interest and taking care of to make dua for them. Now,
second is, I think we should have one session on the concept of money in Islam.
Money.
What is meant by money? How much we should?
Well, this need a lecture.
Yeah, I think we should have some.
Maybe we can arrange a lecture about this.
Or a khutbah based on money.
Khutbah, okay, inshallah.
Because money, you know, what is the concept?
It's
a money is a trust given by Allah to us.
It will come in our.
It
will come, inshallah, in our class, but not now. Because we are in fiqh, and now we are in Bab al Salah. And after we finish al Salah, we will go to what? Zakah. And when we talk about Zakah, we'll talk about money in detail, inshallah.
Because I just came into my mind because I reading one article where one non-Muslim was saying money is a trust.
Nah.
It comes and goes, it's a trust for you.
Nah. Inshallah, we'll talk about
it. That's what. Then it struck to me, it is actually an Islamic concept.
Yes, inshallah. We need to talk about this. We arrange some lecture. Jazakum Allah khair. So see you inshallah next week. May Allah reward you all. Salaam.